Good afternoon, sir, my dear friend. So I am presenting the paper of a direct and indirect current control schemes of single stage distributed TV system. Paper ID is 1389. Myself Abhisek Parida, and the co-author is Bidyadhar. So my outlines will be like this: the introduction, the objectives of the work done, and simulation analysis and discussion. And we'll have a comparative analysis of these two schemes, and then the conclusions and the reference. So the introduction. So as we know that nowadays we are more and more going towards the clean and green energy, and out of that, if you see, the out of the PV and the wind has taken the most significant role. But out of them again, if you see, the PV has taken the most experience, the most growth in the last few years. And but if you see nowadays, PV installations mostly connected to the grid, okay, aiming to become part of the electricity generation mix. Okay, so you see here, basically there are two conditions for a connected PV system. One is a double stage grid connected PV system, and there is a single stage grid connected PV system. So what happens in a double stage grid connected PV system? There are two energy conversion stages. One is a DC to DC converter, which converts this DC voltage to DC, it boosts up, and another is a DC to AC, that is a voltage source inverter. But in a single stage grid connected PV system, it has only one stage of conversion, that is DC to AC and the voltage source inverter. Okay. So what happens that if you see this reference TVMR, it says that the single stage grid connected PV system is obviously cost effective, that we can say, because obviously there is one lesser stage conversion, so the cost of this one goes down, so therefore it is obviously cost effective in that case. And also along with that, you see that it says also that it reduces the power loss due to the use of a single stage. Okay, so that is a double stage, and this is a single stage grid connected PV system. So we are basically working on this single stage grid connected PV system because of this two added advantages. Okay. So basically, if you see, we are saying this as a multifunctional PV system. Why? Because this single voltage source inverter does all the work. Okay, all the work in the sense that the maximum power point tracking, feeding PV power to the grid, balancing the grid currents, as well as the power quality improvement. Okay, so therefore you are saying that this is a multifunctional PV system. The voltage source inverter does all the job. But in a case of a, you see the two stage conversion, the DC to DC part, that does the part of the MPPT, and the rest part is done by the VSI. But here the VSI does all the functions. So therefore you are saying this is a multifunctional PV system. And but if you see, so nowadays when the loads are used, they are basically nonlinear in nature, and due to that the harmonics are injected in the distribution. So the function of the this grid connected PV system is that whenever the power exchange is being done through the grid, either you are taking from the grid or injecting to the grid, it should be done at unity power factor. But due to the presence of this nonlinear load, so harmonics may be injected to the system. Therefore, the whole control algorithm should be designed in such a way that whenever the exchange of power is done through the grid, that is either you are taking from the grid or injecting to the grid, it should be at unity power factor. Okay? So if you see here, so there are two basically control schemes. So has been designed by Singh et al. The 14th reference that I have mentioned, that is, one is a direct current control and there is an indirect current control. So we have basically focused on those two current control methods. We have designed a comparison of for a grid connected PV system. Okay. So basically, these are the challenges for the integration of grid PV to the grid. One is the extraction of maximum PV power under varying environmental conditions. Second is the injection, so injecting the current to the grid at unity power factor. That is one of the objectives that, as I said. Third is the harmonics mitigation of loads connected to the point of common coupling, where the loads are connected, where the PV is connected or the VSI is connected, and where a capacitor, the RC filter is connected, and where the grid is connected. That is known as the PCC point or the point of common coupling. And the fourth one is the balancing of the grid current. That case is when if a particular particular phase of load is disconnected. So what will happen that you need to give the currents to the grid or take the current at unity power factor along with balanced. Okay, so that is one of the challenge objectives. So these are the basically the objectives here we are working on, and we have taken two conditions. One is the change in irradiance condition, and another is the change in the the unbalanced load condition. Based on those two, we have compared the two current control schemes. Okay. So this is basically a configuration of a single stage grid connected PV system. As I said, that there is a PV source, there will be a VSI, there will be no in between DC to DC converter stage, and there will be interfacing inductors. And this is the point of common coupling where this VSI is connected, where this load is connected and the three phase grid is connected. The point of common coupling, but this all four things are connected. Okay, and all the power exchange that happens to the grid, either you take from the grid or you give to the grid, that should be done. Okay, and linear load, so it will cause harmonics, but that harmonics need to be compensated from this side. Okay, whatever power exchange is done from this side, that will be at unit power factor always. So all the active power that is demanded should be fulfilled by the grid, and all the reactive power or the harmonics that should be compensated by the VSA. The control algorithm should be. Okay, so and here is the current controller, and we have used a hysteresis current controller, and based on that we are developing the gate pulses which is giving to the VSA. So out of this, the first stage is the estimation of reference grid current. Since I said that the power exchange with it should be unity power factor, therefore we need to calculate that how much of active power is demanded by the load. Okay, as you see here, the configuration, it is such that we first design that how much demand is for the load set. Okay? What is the, so according to that, whatever active power needs to be demanded, so first that needs to be fulfilled by the PV side. If that extra power is there, that will be injected to the grid. If there is less power, that is if the PV power is less than what is the load demand, then that extra active power will be given by the grid. Okay, so this is our objective. That we need to first determine what is the or how much is the active power demand of the load. So for active power demand of the load, you see that obviously the load current or the load power will have three things. One is the active power, and there is the reactive power, and there is a harmonic component. Since it is Fourier configuration. Okay, so you see the active current is nothing but basically the total average power or the real work done by that. Okay, so if you see, this is the formula for P average, the active power demand by the load. Okay, and if you need to now find out how much is the active current, so you divide just that power divided by the RMS value of the voltage of each phase, and you'll get what is the active power demand by each phase. So ILA will be the P average by VGA, that is the active power demand. That is the active power demand by phase A load current. Okay. Similarly, if you see the other two active power or demand by the other two phases can be calculated. And after that, once you get the active power demand of each phase, then the I total can be calculated by the active power demand of each phase is divided by 3, that is the total active power demand by each phase. Okay. Phase divided. Is the active power demand by each phase. To that we add one loss component and another is the PV component. What does the loss component denotes is basically is the current needed to maintain the DC link voltage. Okay, if you see the next slide, I have the total configuration, I'll show you. So here, this is the total active power demand of each phases divided by 3, you get the total active power demand. Okay, ILA, ILB, ILC divided by 3, that is this one. And there is a MPPT controller. So from there, what is the PI controller that you are getting? That is the loss component. Okay, that is nothing but the current needed to maintain the DC link voltage to its value. And similarly, we are using a PV component term. So this, what it does is that it reduces the burden on the PI controller. So this I total is nothing but I loss plus this ILA plus ILB plus ILC by 3 minus IPV. Okay, so whatever you are getting to this, this is a basically a DC component. Give the current to the grid side at unity power factor, you need to find that what is the phase of each phase, phase of phase A, phase B, phase C. So for that we estimate a unit vector, so that from the grid voltage, so that if you get the unit vector, you get a and multiply it to the DC quantity, then you can have a current that is a AC current which will be in the same phase as that of the grid voltage. Okay, so as you can see, the calculation therefore says that the reference grid current will be, that is IGA star, IGB star and IGC star is nothing but I total, that is a DC quantity, and to that you multiply that XGA, XGB, XGC, which are nothing but the this XGA, XGB, XGC, that is nothing but the estimation of the unit vector, so that you get the current in phase with the grid voltage, such that our one objective was that exchange of current with the grid should be at unit power. So for that you multiply that XGA, XGB, XGC, and we get the reference current, grid current, IGA, IGB and IGC, basically the reference grid current. So now coming to the two current control methods that we are seeing, that is one is a direct current control and another is a indirect current control. So how do we define this two? Basically, as we say that the source that is controlling all the things. Okay, so whatever the current, if you are mentioning that the generating the reference inverter current, then we are saying that as the direct current control. If you are generating this grid current and estimating the reference current of the inverter, then that indirect current control. So basically, direct current control, as I said, that is generating the inverter reference current. But basically, as I said the previously, that we calculated. So we calculated the reference grid current. So from the reference grid current, if you subtract the get, that is the reference inverter current. And coming to the indirect current control, that is only directly we are getting the reference grid current. Okay. And finally, those two are compared using a hysteresis current control to get the gate pulses. Okay. So these are basically the two current control techniques. So as you can see, as direct current control, as I said, that we need to generate the reference inverter current. So from the reference grid current, if you subtract the load current, obviously the thing that we'll get, that is the reference inverter current. And we compare that with actual grid, inverter current, and that we give it to the current controller. We are using here the hysteresis current control to get the gate pulses. But in indirect current control, directly the grid currents is being compared with the actual grid current. That is the current is compared with the actual grid current and the controller to generate the gate pulse. Okay. This is the two current control techniques. So coming to the simulation results and discussion, so we have taken a PV source of 10, and these are the values that we have considered, and one here that is almost giving that 1.02 in 10^4, that is 10 kilowatts. And the DC link voltage, it is not clear here, 749.3 volts. Okay, and these are the parameters that we have chosen for that. So as I said, that we have taken two conditions. One is the change in irradiance condition, and this is the unbalanced load condition. In the change in irradiance condition, we have taken that the irradiance changes from 1000 watt to 0 watt. Okay, considering that it is indicating no sunlight at T equal to 0.55. Similarly, for unbalanced load, what we have done is that one phase of the load, phase C, we have disconnected at the same T equal to 0.55 seconds, and these are the simulation parameters that we have considered. And if you see, this is the response that we are getting. So you can see here, that is the dynamic response during load unbalance. Here you see that at T equal to 0.55 seconds, we are disconnecting one phase of the load. Okay, although we are disconnecting a load at 0.55 seconds, you can see that the grid currents are still balanced. Grid currents are still maintained balanced. Can see that the grid current has increased because obviously the load current demand has reduced. Whatever the extra power is there, that goes now to the grid. So obviously the grid current increases, but all the three phases are maintained balanced in both the cases. Okay, but if you can see here that in the case of this direct current control, the harmonics are little less as compared to the indirect current control. And here also, if you see, the DC link also stabilizes much faster in case of indirect current control as compared to the direct current. Okay, this is one of the condition that we have discussed. The next one is that the response of this two current control methods during irradiation change. You see here irradiation change, what we have done is at T equal to 0.55 seconds, the PV is completely switched off. Therefore at T equal to 0.55 seconds, the load demand is to be fulfilled by the grid side because the PV is now completely switched off. So you can see here the current in both the cases, if you see that there is a change in phase. Till some phase it was out of phase with each other, but after that it becomes in phase with each other. In demand means, it means that your first you are feeding to the grid, but at T equal to 0.55 seconds, the grid is now feeding to the load. Okay, so here you can see that again the grid currents are maintained balanced, and that is at unity power factor, the exchange being done. Okay, as you can see that the voltage, the grid voltage and grid current are in same phase with each other. So if you see the comparative analysis, the computational complexity obviously is less in indirect current control as compared to direct current control, because we are first estimating the grid current, from that you are subtracting the load current to generate the inverter current, but here directly the grid current and the actual was considered. Therefore it is less, oscillations is more in direct current control, and indirect current control it is less. THDs, as you have seen here, both the cases direct current control is more, but as compared to indirect current control it is less, 8.7 and 3.9, which lies well within the IEEE prescribed standards. Okay, So without compensation, here we have taken a load which is around 26%, I think, the harmonics. So you can see the without compensation, the harmonics of each order that is coming, the each harmonics you have given, it comes to around 8.7%, but indirect incremental is coming as 3.9%. So this is the conclusion that we are getting, that the indirect current control offers better harmonic compensation as compared to the direct current control, and which adheres to the IEEE 549 standard. These are some of the selected